So we are here now in the studio of Mr. Pirmin Breu, and this is his atelier, as you can see, and we are in Kadreitzen. So what is art to you? What does it mean to you?
I mean, art is for me like breathing. It's something I can't be without, so it's part of my life.
And I read in your biography that you have been sketching and painting since childhood. And you have been in the States, you have gone to Mexico, and you have been just going around the world to learn art. So tell us a little bit about that.
I travel all over the world because it opens your mind, and I like to see other cultures, I like to see other people, and it just makes me feel more doing my art different, and doing art is for me like learning. So I need always new food to try to get the power to do something new.
And you have some figures which I see they come in many several sketches and canvases. Tell us a little bit about that. How did you come up, I mean, how did you think about it, or what's the inspiration?
I mean, the way I started concentrated about doing my art was I wanted to show the personality of the people, totally simple, with no details, just totally simple. Yeah. So I made these figures, yeah. And for me it was important that that's our figures, which wherever you see it in the world, you realize that these figures are made by me. So if you see it in Mexico, you realize that must be the figure I made. So that's why I hold it on so long to these figures. Mm-hmm. But now with the time they start to change. Mm-hmm. But always when you see it, you see part of my past art I did. Mm-hmm. Because I think it's important to have like a red line through your work.
That's very interesting, because today when I was talking to Frau Widmer, she said the same thing, to have the rote Fade.
Yeah, okay, that's
right.
Interesting.
Yes, yeah. Yes. So, you know, that's why I'm asking more or less the same questions, mm-hmm. and then it's interesting to see. Mm-hmm. And you also have many Swiss themes, and most interesting is graffiti. You have brought graffiti to a very, how to say, international level, and how do you feel about that, your technique?
I mean, when I was young, graffiti just came in the cinemas about the movie Wild Style in the middle of the 80s, and I saw it there. Mm-hmm. And I was the first wave of graffiti writers we had in Switzerland, Europe. Mm-hmm. So I was in this scene since the beginning, and I learned all about it. And it was just so interesting that I still now keep on holding on this background I have. I think it was something really important in my history. So I still have parts of this graffiti in my art, even if it's no more graffiti, because graffiti is just writing illegally, mostly lettering. And I would say what I do now is like street art, because it has like different combinations, like stencil, like pencil, like marker, like brush, spray can. So I would say I stay now at the street art scene.
And you've brought the street art scene on canvases, which anyone can display in their walls. So that's also very interesting. So someone who would like to learn about graffiti, where should they go? Do they get this as a formal education in art colleges, or should they learn from masters, experts? How do they do that?
You know, I go to schools too and teach the kids about graffiti, but the good thing about graffiti, I think, is that all the people who learned graffiti, they didn't go to school for it. They went to see magazines, to the streets, to learn directly, and you had to learn by yourself. That's why they are so powerful. Mm-hmm. All these graffiti writers from back in the days, these are really powerful on strong people, because they didn't go to school for it. They
Original.
Had to learn everything themselves. That's why this scene is so strong. And even if they are architectures architecture or teacher or whatever they are, yes. after it, yeah. they are doing this with passion, and
yes.
That makes it really special.
Yes.
So I think it's gonna be really boring when you go to school to learn about graffiti, because graffiti is a lifestyle,
yes.
which you have to fight for it, to find out the whole thing. It's not something you just learn in school. It's,
right.
I think, would be the wrong way. I teach the ground parts of it in school, but if you want to be a good graffiti writer, then you have to do it by yourself. You have to practice, you have to be really strong with yourself, and then you're going to be a good artist,
right.
And not just because you go into the school and hear what's important.
Yeah. So graffiti is more about the idea and less about the execution, or how would you say that?
Graffiti is, I mean, in our days now, we would say graffiti is like the own scene for the graffiti writers, not for the community. And it's just made with lettering. That's graffiti. If you see the other stuff, which you see a lot now here, it's like street art. It's like a combination. It's like lettering. It's like characters. It's like using stencils. It's like using brushes. It's a combination. So then I would call it street art. So graffiti for me is just lettering, writing illegally for the scene. So that's a big difference.
Thank you so much. Thank
You're
you so
welcome.
Much for this wonderful interview.